Okay, so we've established that ideal occlusion is important, but where do the teeth need to be to achieve ideal occlusion? To find out, we turn to two of the most inventive pioneers in orthodontics, Dr. Angle and Dr. Andrews. Born on a Pennsylvania farm in 1855, Dr. Edward Angle is considered the father of modern orthodontics. He invented ingenious mechanical appliances for moving teeth and created the broad classifications of malocclusion that orthodontists still use today. Dr. Angle believed that the most fundamental characteristic of ideal occlusion was a proper molar relationship. He found that in patients with healthy bites, the mesiobuccal cusp of the first upper molar occludes in the buccal groove of the first lower molar. Dr. Angle called this ideal configuration a class 1 molar relationship. When lined up properly, the cusps of the upper molars mesh into the grooves in the lower molars like gears, so that the teeth can chew efficiently. If the mesiobuccal cusp of the upper first molar is anterior to this groove by the width of a premolar or more, it's considered a class 2 molar relationship. If the upper cusp is posterior to this groove by the width of a premolar or more, it's called a class 3 molar relationship. Angle system can also be used to classify the canine relationship. In an ideal class 1 canine relationship, the distal slope of the upper canine coincides with the embrasure between the lower canine and first premolar. If the upper canine is significantly anterior to this embrasure, it's a class 2 canine relationship. If the upper canine is significantly posterior to this embrasure, it's a class 3 canine relationship. Angle system is very useful, but there are still many kinds of malocclusion that can't be summed up by a simple class number. In 1960, an orthodontist in San Diego named Lawrence Andrews grew frustrated with this imprecision. He reasoned that in order to accurately diagnose all the various types of malocclusion, he would first need to identify and define the fundamental characteristics of ideal occlusion. Dr. Andrews began collecting study models from people with naturally ideal dentition. These people had never received orthodontic treatment, but their teeth looked straight and their bite was generally correct. Dr. Andrews measured and analyzed over 120 of these study models to discover the traits they held in common. Then he tested his findings by comparing them to over 1,000 study models from orthodontists across the country. After 12 years of research, he published his defining achievement in 1972, The Six Keys to Normal Occlusion. Andrews' six keys start with something familiar, interarch relationships. Teeth in ideal occlusion should have a class 1 molar and canine relationship, as described by Dr. Engel. Dr. Andrews also specified that the distal surface of the upper first molar's distobuccal cusp should occlude with the mesial surface of the lower second molar's mesiobuccal cusp. Andrews' second key is crown angulation, the mesial or distal angle of the crown. Some doctors refer to crown angulation as tip. This is the angle formed by the facial axis of the clinical crown and a line perpendicular to the occlusal plane, from a facial perspective. Crown angulation is considered positive if the occlusal portion of the facial axis is mesial to the gingival portion, and negative if it's distal. In an ideal arch, all the crowns should be angled positively. In other words, the crowns should tilt mesially from the gums. It's important to note that we're evaluating the facial axis of the clinical crown, not the long axis of the entire tooth. On all the teeth except molars, the facial axis is the most prominent portion of the central lobe on the crown's facial surface. On molars, the facial axis is the buccal groove that separates the two large facial cusps. The third key is crown inclination, the facial or lingual angle of the crown. This is the angle formed by the facial axis of the clinical crown and the line perpendicular to the occlusal plane from a mesial perspective. Crown inclination is considered positive if the occlusal portion of the facial axis is facial to the gingival portion, and negative if it's lingual. In an ideal arch, all of the crowns are inclined positively. In other words, the crowns should tilt facially from the gums. Crown inclination is sometimes incorrectly referred to as torque. Torque actually refers to the twisting force, which is traditionally required to adjust the inclination of a crown. Andrew's fourth key is rotations. This is an easy one. The teeth should be free of undesirable rotations. A rotated molar won't occlude properly and may occupy too much space in the arch. Andrew's fifth key is spaces. This is another simple one. You don't want spaces. Unless there's a genuine tooth size discrepancy, the contacts should be tight. And the final key is the curve of speed. This describes the curvature of the occlusal plane. The curve of speed should be flat, or slightly concave. A deeply concave curve won't allow enough space for the upper teeth, and a convex curve will spread them out too far. So to recap, Dr. Engel created a classification system for molar and canine relationships. Class 1 is the ideal relationship. The mesiobuccal cusp of the first upper molar occludes in the buccal groove of the first lower molar. The distal slope of the upper canine lines up with the embrasure between the lower canine and the first premolar. A class 2 relationship means the upper tooth is anterior to the ideal relationship, and a class 3 relationship means the upper tooth is posterior to the ideal relationship. Dr. Andrews expanded upon this to create the 6 keys to normal occlusion. Interarch relationships. Molars and canines should be class 1. Crown angulation. Crowns should tilt mesially. Crown inclination. Crown should tilt facially. There shouldn't be any rotations. There shouldn't be any spaces. And the curve of sphe should be flat or slightly concave. Evaluating these aspects of your patient's occlusion can help you identify dental problems. And that's what we're going to discuss in our next video.